Hello, how are you today? Hello, hello.
Good evening.
Good evening, how are you?
I'm fine.
Fine, fine, excellent.
Thank you.
How was your weekend? Did you have a nice weekend? Mm-hmm.
I work.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, how are you? How was your weekend? Mm-hmm.
Good, teacher.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, how are you? Did you have a nice weekend? Yes. Did you sleep a lot? Yeah. Okay, that's the best part of the weekend, right? That we can sleep a little bit more. Oh no, you don't sleep on the weekend?
No, todavía no.
No. Okay, so that means that you work on the weekend? Yes. ¿Trabajan el fin de semana?
No work.
Yes. Yes, sí.
Oh, that's sad. Me too. Me too. But sometimes I wish I didn't. It's nice when we have a day off on the weekend, right? It's like, it's very, very relaxed. Okay. Vamos a pasar a attendance. Okay. ¿Qué tal de tormenta por su casa? Cuéntenme.
Bastante tropical la tormenta esta noche, de hecho. Yo nada más ahorita me estaba comunicando con mi mamá que se ha quedado trabada ahí en un tráfico de que se han caído unos árboles por donde vive, no se puede pasar ya. Lleva más de 2 horas en el tráfico.
Ouch. Y más que con estas tormentas no puede decir uno me voy a bajar y voy a caminar porque a ponerse en riesgo, ¿va?
¿Verdad? Peor en la zona rural.
Ah, sí, sí, sí. Una correntada. Dios guarde, entonces bueno, ni modo, voy a esperar que pase. Sí, aquí ha habido una tormenta, si yo pensando, ay Dios, a ver si no nos toca reprogramar la clase con todo esto que venía, que ya parecía que iba a caer, pero exagerada, y sí cayó fuerte, pero para como sonaba desde tipo 6 y 20, yo dije, va a estar...
Era para un buen apagón de luz.
Exacto, exacto. Pero lo único que se escuchaba allá, bien arriba, bien arriba, si le digo yo a mi esposo, hace tiempos que no tenemos una tormenta como esta, que se escuchaba una gran tronazón, pero que se oía bien lejos, o sea, bien arriba y va de, como que le estaban tomando fotos.
Un montón de relámpagos.
Sí, un montón de relámpagos.
Sí, la verdad es que sí, bastante fuertecita. Pobrecita la gente que ay, sufre.
Yo solo pensé, Dios, guardia, andar en la calle ahorita. Pero todos llegaron, ¿verdad? A su casa.
Ahí está viendo que hay uno, que está inundaciones, los buses se han quedado inundados con un montón de gente.
Me imagino que sí, yo noticias no he visto. Pero me imagino que sí, que cuando llueve así en muy poco tiempo, una cantidad como la que ha llovido, se pone feíto. Pero,
sí, hace bastantes estragos.
Sí, primero Dios que no se complique, ¿verdad? Y que no pase nada grave.
Primeramente Dios que no.
Así es. Vaya, vamos a ver. ¿Es Ángel here? Ángel. No here, Ángel, yet. Okay. Aristides?
Present.
Excellent. Denia Guadalupe. Denia. Denia. No. Eduardo Ernesto. Eduardo. Edwin Orlando.
Present.
Okay. Fátima Xiomara. Fátima no yet. Isabel.
Present.
Okay. Luis Mauricio. Luis, no here. María Martínez.
Presente.
Hola, Patia.
¿Qué tal? ¿Ya llegó a casita? Sí.
Ya casi llego.
Ah, vale, por lo menos, sí, ¿verdad? Marisela. Marisela, no here. Marlene. Marlene.
Presente. Presente.
Ah, usted sí ya está en casita, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Excelente, Marlene. Maura Irene. Maura. Maura. No here. Nidia Marilyn. Oscar.
Present, teacher.
Oscar, yo dije, hoy no se va a conectar Oscar con esta.
No, hombre, sí, está lloviendo un poquito, me agarró la señal y estos días ha estado mala la señal, por eso el viernes ya no.
Pero mire qué bueno, como que la tormenta vino a llevarle más poder
en ojalá su casa. Sí, porque me está costando entrar ahorita, por mi señal se va.
Pero primero Dios que se quede completo, ¿verdad?
Ojalá que sí.
Ok, Ricardo. Ricardo, ay, Ricardo, ha de estar manejando todavía. Teresa.
Present, teacher, good night. Perdón, no había saludado.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Excellent. Walter, is Walter here? Walter, no here.
Present, teacher.
Ah, yo dije, se durmió con la tormenta. No molestamos a Walter. Yesenia.
Teacher, buenas noches.
Buenas
noches, teacher. ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo está?
Qué barbaridad. ¿Cómo se me ha
metido? Disculpas que no había podido entrar, teacher.
Sí.
Pero eran problemas personales de salud.
Perdón. Hay que cuidarse un poquito con estas lluvias. Y qué bueno que ya estamos, ¿verdad? Ya estamos. Yuri.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Vayamos, sí. Ya vamos. Alguien que haya llegado y que no estaba cuando lo llamé.
Ay.
Ah, Luis.
Hello.
Hello. Luis.
I'm here.
Only you, right? Ángel no here yet.
I think. No.
Ok. Luis no. Mauricio, present.
Present.
Who is the other? I have Angel. No here.
No here.
Denia. Eduardo Ernesto. Fátima. Segunda vuelta. Marisela. No. Maura. Nidia. Y Ricardo. Okay. Estamos bien. Estamos los que estamos. Okay.
Eduardo me dijo que estaba mala la señal, por eso no se había conectado.
Ah, ok. Es que el Inter se nos hace trampa. Vaya, chicos. I'm going to share the screen. Vamos a ver. Okay. This no es nuestra clase número 3. Ok, vaya, vamos a hacer una breve review de la daily routine, right? That's what we were talking about last week. We say, I get up, but remember, she gets up, right? I get up, but he gets up. I have breakfast, but she has breakfast, right? I take a shower, but she what? I take a shower, she?
Takes a shower.
Takes a shower, exactly. I prepare coffee. She prepares
coffee.
She prepares coffee. I drink coffee.
She drinks.
Yes, I drink coffee.
I drink coffee, she drinks coffee. I brush my teeth. She?
Yes.
She brushes her teeth.
Her.
I get dressed. She?
Get dressed. I think she gets.
She gets. Mm-hmm. I get dressed, she gets dressed. I teach a class. She
teaches a class.
She teaches. Mm-hmm. She teaches a class. I check emails.
She checks emails.
She checks emails. Yeah. I prepare lunch.
She prepares lunch.
I change clothes.
She changes clothes.
She changes clothes. I wash the dishes. She?
Yes.
She washes the dishes.
I check homework.
He checks homework.
I send reports.
She sends reports.
I prepare classes.
He prepares classes.
I write reports.
She writes reports.
I attend clients.
She attends clients.
I register the invoice.
She registers the invoice, right?
I play soccer.
He plays soccer.
I go to church.
She goes to church on Sundays.
He exercises. I watch movies on TV.
She watches movies on TV.
Mm-hmm. He watches movies on TV. I listen to music. Well, today, this is a review of what we were learning last week, right? Thursday and Friday. We were talking about routine and we were talking about the simple question and the singular. Today we are going to be talking about countable and uncountable nouns, right? Countable. Okay, this is another topic we were talking about, using expressions for regular activities. Remember, we say every day, every week, every month, every year, right? Daily, weekly, monthly. These are expressions that we use to describe activities that are common, right? That we do, that are repetitive activities, we can say, right? Activities for our daily routine, or weekly routine, or monthly routine, right? Now, and we have on the other side, we have once a week, once a day, once a month, once a year, twice, you say twice a day, twice a week, twice a month, twice a year, twice, right? Once, one time, pero no decimos one time, decimos once, right? Twice, no decimos two times, sino que twice. Pero cuando llegamos a tres, ya decimos three times. Ahí ya no decimos thrice, sonaría rarísimo, ¿verdad? Decimos three times a day, three times a week, three times a month, three times a year. For example, if I ask you, how often do you go to the movies? I go to the movies. Aquí vamos a agregar otra expresión, porque no así como que cada rato, casi nunca. De nuevo, say, aquí la voy a poner. Uy, qué recto. Once in a blue moon. Ya habían oído esa expresión ustedes. Once in a, hoy tocaba, hoy que me acuerdo, hoy tocaba luna llena, ¿verdad?
No sé. Sí.
Porque ayer estaba, pero enorme en la luna, casi, casi así, un poquito le faltaba para redonda. Hoy tocaba llena, no espera. Vaya, hablando de la luna. Ok, se dice, once in a blue moon. Once in a blue means allá. En nosotros en español decimos una vez al siglo, ¿verdad? Porque una blue moon no es común. Tenemos la luna roja de sangre, que es más común. La full moon, que es la luna llena, ¿verdad? Pero a blue moon es así como que no muy común. Entonces, cuando queremos dar una expresión que se refiere a algo que es allá, no muy frecuente, que pasa allá, a los tiempos, decimos once in a blue moon. So, if you ask me, how often do you go to the movies? I will say, once in a blue moon. I go to the movies once in a blue moon. Shandaya, una vez al siglo, ya ni siquiera once a year. Ya ni es. No voy al cine, creo que desde como el 2010. Imagine, so that's a lot, right? Since 2017, más o menos, creo.
2017.
Sí, so that's a lot of time. So I go to the movies once in a blue moon. Entonces, acá, ustedes van a utilizar eso para expresar la frequency, right? Frequency. How often do you check emails? I check emails every day. Todos los días I check emails. Pero si usted checa emails, como puede ser un poco más específico, o sea, checo emails como 3-4 veces al día, right? So, about 3 or 4 times a day. Lo reviso en la mañana, después más tarde, después a mediodía y después al final del día. ¿Ok? Then you can be more specific. How often do you check reports? I check reports daily. How often do you write reports? I write reports weekly. Semanalmente. I'm not being specified exactly when. No digo así como cuándo exactamente, pero semanalmente, right? So I write reports every week. Yeah, I can say I write reports every week. Pero si digo every week, podría ser que todos los días durante o a la semana pase escribiendo reportes. Pero cuando usted dice I write a weekly report, el reporte que usted escribe es de toda la semana, right? Entonces, esta palabra nos ayuda a cambiar el significado de lo que estamos diciendo. I write a weekly report. I write a daily report. O sea, es el reporte de todo el día. Al final del día, en algunos lugares, escriben un reporte de todo lo que hicieron durante el día. Right? Then you say, I write a daily report. I write a weekly report. El viernes, al final del día, el viernes, a reportar toda la semana. Right? O I write a monthly report. Gente de contabilidad. Right? So you can say, I write a monthly report. Allá, a final del mes. Para el IVA, right? So, I write a monthly report. Any questions here? No? Está fácil. Yes. A piece of cake. Yeah? Okay. Ahora, si nos vamos a lo que nos atañe. Check. Today, vamos a hablar de un par de cosas. Una, countable and uncountable nouns. Y la otra, how much and how many. Vamos a empezar primero por identificar cuáles son los uncountable nouns. Uncountable. Tengo tea. Tea, no importa qué tipo de té, no se cuenta. Usted puede contar las bolsitas de té o las tazas de té que se toma. Pero el té, 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 no. ¿Verdad? Sugar. The same. Puede contar las cucharas. How many spoons of sugar? O puede contar las libras de azúcar, pero no puede contar los granitos, right? So sugar is not countable. Water. Water. I can count a cup or a, yeah, this is a cup. A cup of water, right? But I cannot say, give me a water. A water, ¿cómo le doy un agua? Le doy una botella, un vaso, una bolsa de agua, ¿qué, qué? ¿Verdad? Entonces, water is no countable. Air. Air, ni lo vemos, ni lo contamos, right? So, the air is and then we have rice. Rice. El arroz tampoco lo podemos contar. Knowledge. El conocimiento. ¿Cuánto conocimiento tengo yo acá? I cannot count, right? How much knowledge? How much knowledge have you gotten? How much knowledge do you have here? La belleza. La belleza no la puedo contar. ¿Verdad? So you say beauty, no countable. Anger, anger, el enojo, right? Mm-mm. El miedo, fear, el amor, love, money. I cannot count it. There are some other things that I cannot count. For example, vamos a darle acá. For example, coffee. So we say shoe, tea, coffee. ¿Qué más? Milk. I cannot count the milk.
Chocolate.
Chocolate. Yes. Si va a hablar de chocolate, puede decir chocolate bars o chocolate or a cup of chocolate. Una barra de chocolate.
O una taza de chocolate.
Taza de chocolate, una galleta de chocolate. Pero el muy chocolate no puedo contar. A ver, ¿qué más? Chicken.
Sam.
¿Puedo contar el chicken? ¿Qué me dicen?
Yo digo que sí, las piezas. Los pollos se pueden contar.
Las piezas, exactly. Uh-huh. So I can say chicken legs, chicken wings, chicken breast, right? Las piezas del chicken, sí. I want 2 pounds of chicken. I want 2 pieces of chicken, 2 wings, 2 chicken legs. Pero así, el pollo, pollo, si está muerto, is uncountable. Lo que yo puedo contar es el pollo vivo, ¿sí? Cuando andan ahí corriendo, you can count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 chickens. No problem, you can count them. Pero si el pollo ya está cocinado en la cacerola, ya no puedo. ¿Ok? Ya pollo muerto is uncountable. Todos los animales muertos son uncountable. ¿Ok? The fish in the river, cuando está vivo y anda nadando, fish tiene plural, right? So you can say fish. Pero si estamos hablando del fish cuando ya está ahí muerto para comérmelo, ya no es contable. ¿Ok? Meat. I can count the cows, right? ¿Cuántas vacas? How many cows? Pero no puedo decir how many meat. I say how much meat. Entonces, meat también es uncountable. ¿Ya? Meat is uncountable. No puedo contar la meat. Also, wine. How much wine? Todas las bebidas son uncountable. Ya aquí usted puede decir una botella, 2 botellas, un vaso, una copa, pero no puede decir one wine. ¿Por qué? Porque cuando hablamos de uncountable nouns, they are for things that we cannot count with numbers. O sea, no con números. I cannot say, give me 2 coffees. No, give me 2 cups. Of coffee. Allí sí, yo puedo contarme. ¿Sí? How much coffee do you drink? I drink a lot of coffee. How much coffee do you drink? I drink a little coffee. Well, no much. Vamos a ver, tenemos otras palabras acá.
Flowers.
Las flowers, sí, podemos contarlas. Así. Fíjense que hay varias cosas que son contables, pero infinitas. Por ejemplo, el caso de las estrellas. Las estrellas son contables, ¿verdad? Entonces, yo puedo decir, how many stars do you see? No how much stars, pero how much sun. La arena, vamos a escribir la arena acá. La arena es no contable, pero las estrellas son contable. Yo puedo contar las estrellas. Lo único es que voy a empezar a contar y me voy a perder. Voy a empezar a contar de nuevo las que ya había contado. Entonces, son infinitas, que es muy diferente, right? Infinite to uncountable. Uncountable es algo que no puedo ocupar números yo para contar, ¿ok? No puedo usar números, no tienen plural. O sea, no puedo decir, ah, vaya, el plural de tea es teas. El plural de coffee es coffees. El plural de sugar es sugars. No, that's not possible. Porque estas palabras no tienen plural, ¿ok? No tienen plural, ninguna de las... salvo chicken, ¿verdad? Que hablábamos de que chicken, si el chicken está vivo, es contable, pero si está muerto, no. ¿Ok? Entonces, ya saben, todo aquello que no tiene plural es uncountable. ¿Sí? Usted perfectamente puede decir how many flowers? How many colors? Yeah, how many colors? Y los colores los puede contar, pero no podemos contar todas estas dimensiones. Vamos a ver. Let's go to the next page. Check. Aquí hay unas palabras que son, en otros idiomas son contables, pero en inglés no. Y me las traigo para acá porque en el contexto en que nosotros estemos utilizando el how much y el how many, de repente nos puede salir alguna de ellas, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, news. News, news es uncountable. Las noticias en español, right? En español son las noticias. En inglés, the news. The news is not countable. Entonces recuerden, estas son palabras que son contables en otros idiomas, pero en inglés son uncountable. ¿Ok? Progress. How much progress? Por ejemplo, si yo les pregunto a ustedes, how much progress do you see in the platform? How much progress does the platform show? How much progress? No, how many progress, right? Progress is uncountable. Traffic. Fíjense que esta palabra traffic, y hay varias así, que ya vamos a ver, por ejemplo, en esta que vimos, money. A veces me dicen, teacher, pero ¿por qué money is uncountable? Sí, yo puedo contar el dinero. Sí, usted puede contar el dinero, pero la palabra dinero no tiene plural. Right? No puedo decir los dineros. That's not possible. No sé en español, pero al menos en inglés. Right? So you say, money. Money, money, no tiene plural, right? How much money? How much money do you have? Por ejemplo, si le pregunto, how much money do you carry around? No es que lo anda pegado, pero ¿cuánto dinero carga? Yes. How much money do you carry around? ¿Cuánto dinero anda con usted? Right? So, how much money? Y money incluye coins, bills. We can be talking about dollars, que colones, pesos, yenes, libras, euros, right? It doesn't matter. Pero you can count the coins, you can count the bills, you can count the dollars, $1, $2, right? But no one money, two monies. That's not possible, not two monies. And the same happens with traffic. When we talk about traffic, es el tráfico en general. El tráfico, bueno, in Spanish, traffic is singular too, right? And here, in English, traffic is uncountable. Traffic includes cars, bicycles, motorcycles, minivans, vans, talking about traffic. Yeah, all the means of transportation make traffic. Then traffic is uncountable. Also, travel. How much travel? Yeah. Or travel. Travel. Travel, problema, right? Problems in plural. You can say one problem, two problems, but how much travel did you get? How much travel? Travel is not countable. El clima, cuando yo hablo del clima, no digo los climas, right? I say the weather. The weather is crazy, right? The weather is crazy. During the day it is hot, at night it is cold, and sometimes with electric storms, okay? So the weather is, no plural, right? Work. Cuando yo le pregunto a usted, how much work? No puedo decir how many works, porque work no tiene plural. Yes? How much work? Accommodation. Accommodation, cuando nosotros hablamos de accommodation, nos referimos a un lugar donde quedarse, a dormir, ¿verdad? Entonces, puede entrar R&B, hotels, motels, any place for you to, a cottage, whatever, ¿verdad? Cualquier cosa donde usted pueda quedarse. Pero la palabra accommodation es uncommon. Advice. En español, nosotros decimos sugerencias, right? El buzón de sugerencias. Escriba sus sugerencias. But in English, you say, please give me your advice. No advices. Y este es un error bastante común que tendemos a decir advices, pero no se puede. ¿Ok? No se puede. Decimos advice, no advices. ¿Ok? Baggage. ¿Qué es baggage? ¿Quién sabe?
Equipaje.
Uh-huh. Exactly. Exactly. Cuando usted viaja, ¿verdad? Cuando usted viaja, lleva un equipaje. Entonces, ese es baggage. How much, le preguntan en el aeropuerto, how much baggage do you carry? How much baggage? No, how many baggages, right? How much baggage? How many bags? Yes? How much baggage? Entonces, la palabra baggage, a pesar de que incluye la carry-on bag, de computer bag, no me acuerdo cómo se llama la más grande, pero incluye todas las bags. Pero la palabra baggage is no countable, no la puedo contar. Behavior, el comportamiento, right? His behavior is. No puedo decir his behavior are. ¿Ok? Behavior. Bread. El pan. En español nosotros decimos los panes. ¿Verdad? Mira, pásame dos panes. In English, no. You cannot say, can you pass me two breads? That's not possible. Porque bread no tiene. Y ya que estamos acá con bread. Algo bien importante, nosotros en español tenemos el pan dulce, ¿verdad? Pero no podemos traducirlo literal a sweet bread, porque eso no existe, ¿sí? No existe. Nosotros en inglés decimos pastry. Podría ser pastry o simple bread. O podemos llamar el pan por su nombre, como muffin, ¿qué? The names of each of the types of bread. Y si nos referimos a un pancito chiquito, it's a piece of bread. ¿Verdad? Piece. En inglés, cuando decimos a piece, no nos referimos a un pedacito. Igual, con a piece of paper, paper. Paper is not countable. No me refiero a un pedacito de papel, como la teacher dijo, que un pedacito de papel. ¿Saben qué está un pedacito de papel? No. No me refiero a eso. A piece of paper es una página entera, ¿verdad? Una página entera, arrancada del cuaderno, pero una página entera. That's a piece of paper. ¿Ok? Ahora, si yo digo a piece of bread, puede ser un bollito de pan. Un pancito de los chiquitos que nosotros compramos, que de repente todavía los hallamos a 20 centavos, ¿verdad? Uno de esos, ¿ok? That's a piece of bread. O podemos también usar a slice of bread, la rebanada de pan como la del pan de caja. O la rebanada de pan que cortamos para hacer las torrejas, ¿right? That would be a slice. Slice of bread. Y si no, si lo que queremos es una torta de pan, entonces decimos a loaf of bread. Loaf. A loaf of bread. Eso sí lo puedo contar. Yo puedo contar a piece of bread, a loaf of bread, a slice of bread, no problem. Lo que no puedo contar es bread solito. So no puedo decir a bread, hey, give me a bread. Give me a loaf of bread, give me a piece of bread, or a slice of bread. Okay? Ahora, vamos con la palabra furniture. furniture es una palabra que yo ocupo para referirme a los muebles. Por ejemplo, it includes bed, table, chairs. That's furniture. Todo lo que es de madera, right? That's furniture. Los muebles. Los muebles. In Spanish es contable. Y por eso es que les traje esta referencia porque estas son las que tienden a confundirnos un poquito. Porque, por ejemplo, si yo digo el arroz, el agua, el café, hay mayor problema, ¿verdad? Pero para decir los muebles, las noticias, ¿verdad? Ya en español para mí son plurales, pero en inglés no. Ok, furniture is singular. So you say, this furniture is very beautiful, but it's very expensive. Mm-hmm. So furniture is no contable. Information, la información, no contable. The information is important. Yes. How much information do you have? Information. Mm? Uncountable. Luggage. Luggage. También luggage se refiere a equipaje, igual que baggage. Pero baggage son ya como las maletas más grandes, right? Pero luggage igual, equipaje. Entonces, no countable. Ahora, I have some examples here. I would like to give you some advice. Check. Dijimos advice, sugerencias in Spanish, but in English, no countable. No lleva S, no tiene S. Advice, no puedo decir advices, right? Vamos a usar some. I'd like to give you some advice. No an advice. Es bien común que se, te quiero dar una sugerencia. I want to give you an advice. That's not possible. Okay? So you say, give you some advice. Vamos a ver dentro de poquito, por ejemplo, some. Yo puedo usar some para las cosas que no puedo contar y para las que puedo. Okay? Now, how much bread? How much bread should I bring? How much? ¿Cuánto? No precio en este momento, sino que cuánto. Chequen que el how much también lo usamos para preguntar por precio. How much is your cell phone? Right? How much is your cell phone? How much bread do you eat? How much coffee do you drink? How much? ¿Sí? Entonces, much lo vamos a usar con uncountable. So remember, bread is no countable. Yo uso how much. I didn't make much progress. I didn't make much progress today. Yeah. This looks like a lot of trouble. Trouble. I will use a lot. A lot es una palabra que yo puedo utilizar con countable y con uncountable. ¿Sí? A lot of trouble, a lot of money, a lot of time. El tiempo tampoco se puede contar, right? No digo los tiempos. Cuando usted mira, por ejemplo, how much time, pero how many times, how much time se refiere al tiempo y how many times se refiere a veces. ¿Sí? Hay diferencia ahí. How much time do you spend studying English? How much time do you spend studying English? ¿Cuánto tiempo pasa estudiando inglés? How many times do you study English in a week? Yo ya ahí pregunto cuántas veces a la semana estudia, right? It's different. We did an hour of work. Work. Check it. Si yo quiero contar work, le pongo algo. Una hora de trabajo. How much work did you do yesterday? I did an hour of work. ¿Sí? How much work do you have? Oh, I have a lot of work. ¿Y cómo a lot lo puedo usar para cualquiera? ¿Contable o no? ¿O uncountable? No problem. ¿Sí? No puedo decir many. This looks like many trouble to me. It's not possible. Porque many no lo puedo usar en affirmative. many solo lo ocupo en preguntas y en negativos. So you say, how many pupusas do you eat? How many pupusas do you eat? Then you say, oh, I eat a lot of pupusas. No puede decir I eat many pupusas. ¿Ok? Porque many no puede ser usado en affirmative, sino que solamente en negative. I don't eat many pupusas. Allí sí. No como muchas. Solo dos. Right? I don't eat many pupusas. Oh, I eat a lot of pupusas. Right? No sé si tienen alguna pregunta acá. Questions, chicos. ¿No? ¿Todo claro? Como la chata. ¿Todo claro? ¿No preguntas?
No question.
Ok, perfecto. Vamos a ver. Bye, now check this. ¿Cuándo usamos how much? Decimos how much is used with uncountable nouns. Ya vimos cuáles son las uncountable, son a todos aquellos que no se pueden contar. Right? So I use how much with uncountable nouns. Tengo how much más el uncountable noun. How much time? Time, ¿se acuerdan que le decía time no se puede contar? How much time? ¿Ven esta letra o la hago blanca? ¿La logran ver? Sí, no. No.
Sí, ¿no? Se ve. Blanca.
La blanca se ve mejor que negra. No sé por qué la dejé negra. Vamos a ir la blanca. Es que en azul me gusta más poner la blanca porque sí, yo sé que se ve más claro. Tapó la naricita. Vaya. So, we say, how much time? How much time do we have to finish the exercise? ¿Cuánto tiempo tenemos para terminar el ejercicio? 5 minutes. 2 minutes. O cuando le dice Zoom, 1 minute to close, right? So how much time do we have to finish the exercise? How much money, ¿se acuerdan? Money is not countable. How much money did you spend today? How much money? ¿Cuánto dinero? Right? How much money did you spend today? How much sugar do you like in your coffee? How much? Sugar, do you like in your coffee? I like a tip of a spoon. O sea, así, la puntita de la cuchara, nada más. So not a complete spoon of sugar. So how much sugar do you like in your coffee? How much milk is there in the fridge? How much milk? Yeah. How much television do you watch? No es cuántas televisores mira, cuánta televisión mira, right? Si yo dijera, how many televisions do you see? Aún cambio el verbo, porque es cuántos televisores ve. Se imagina, va a una tienda, a una comercial, donde vendan electrodomésticos, televisores y todo eso. Está parado afuera y yo le digo, how many televisions do you see? Allí sí usted puede decir, I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ok, pero how many televisions do you see? Pero si se trata de watch, es how much television do you watch? ¿Qué tanta televisión mira? ¿Qué tanta televisión mira? ¿Cuánta televisión mira? And you say, oh, I watch a lot of television. I watch television every time I can. Oh, I don't watch much television. Por ejemplo, hoy, si usted le pregunta a los adolescentes, le dicen, I don't watch much television. I watch TikToks, I watch photos in Instagram, I like videos in YouTube, but I don't watch television, right? Entonces, esta es la pregunta, how much television? Questions? No question. Sí, no. ¿Cómo responderíamos esta pregunta? Si decimos, how much time do we have to finish the exercise? We don't have much time, right? We don't have much time. We have a lot of time. O podemos dar el tiempo así en minutos o en horas, right? We have 5 minutes. How much money did you spend today? I didn't spend much. I spent a lot. I spent a little. Oh, I spent $5. I spent $6. I spent $10, right? How much sugar do you like in your coffee? I like 1 spoon of sugar. O puede responder con not much, not much, no mucha. Si quiere dar una respuesta así como corta, right? Not much. How much sugar do you like in your coffee? Not much, right? Not much. How much money did you spend today? Just a little, so un poquito. A little. A little es una palabra para usarla con cosas que yo no cuento. Solo un poquito, no, no mucho, right? How much money did you spend today? Just a little, only $6, right? How much money did you spend today? I spent a lot, yeah? I spent a lot. A lot es bastante, un montón, right? En buen salvadoreño, right? So I spent a lot. Or I didn't spend much. O simplemente not much, en una forma más relajada, más informal, right? How much milk is there in your fridge? ¿Cuánta leche hay en su refri? There is a lot. Un galón. Yeah. There is a lot. A lot. There is a lot. Oh, there is not much. Oh, there is a little. There is some. There is some. Hay un poco. Hay un poco, no mucho. Hay un poco. Yeah. How much television do you watch?
There is too little.
There is a little. Sí. There is a little. Hay un poquito. Hay un poquito. No hay mucho. There isn't much. ¿Verdad? Or there is a lot. Hay como 3 gallons de leche. So there is a lot. Okay. How much television do you watch every day? Just a little. Just 2 hours me puede dar también. Este, recuerde que lo que decíamos, usted no puede contar así, no puede decirme, ah, how many television do you watch? How much television do you watch? Pero al momento que usted quiere responder, si no quiere usar, por ejemplo, si no quiere usar a lot o a little, aquí podría decir just a little. O I watch a lot of television. I watch a lot of television. O me puede dar un número. I watch just 2 hours. I watch just 2 hours of television every week. 2 horas a la semana es bien poco, right? Is that clear for you? Sí. Sí, teacher, no teacher.
Mm-hmm. Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. Y nos vamos. How many? Checking. How much es para quantity? No lo estamos usando ahorita para precio, ¿verdad? No vamos a usarlo como precio porque no quiero confundirlos. Lo vamos a usar el how much como para cantidad. ¿Cuánto? ¿Cuánto tiempo, cuánto dinero, cuánta azúcar, cuánta leche, cuánta televisión, cuánto trabajo tiene? Right? How much work do you have? ¿Sí? Entonces, ¿cómo? ¿Cuánto? Ahora vamos al how many. We use how many with plurals. Plural countable nouns. Entonces, cada vez que usamos how many, su noun va a estar en plural. ¿Ya? Siempre que usamos el how many, su noun va a estar en plural. ¿Por qué? Porque puedo contarlos. Entonces, esta es una cantidad que yo puedo contar con números. How much? No. I cannot count with numbers. Pero how many? Sí, I can count it with numbers. Then you say, how many days? How many people, ¿se acuerdan? Person, people. Entonces, yo puedo contar la gente, ¿sí? 2 people, 3 people, 5 people, 10, 100 people. ¿Sí? How many people? How many days are there in January? ¿Cuántos días hay en enero? A ver. ¿Cuántos?
31.
Voy a dar una respuesta corta porque ustedes ya saben. 31 days. Ustedes a esta altura ya saben que para responder una pregunta retomamos parte de la pregunta para escribir la respuesta. Right? How many days are there in January? There are 31 days. In January. Esa sería la respuesta completa. There are 31 days in January. ¿Ya? A ver, how many people work in your company? How many? In my company, there work.
In my company, work 7 people.
Mm-hmm. In my company work. ¿Qué pasa si yo no quiero dar un número? Es como el anterior. Si yo no quiero dar un número, yo uso a little, not much, a lot, or some. There is some. How much sugar do you like in your coffee? Not much. I like so much. How much milk is there in your fridge? There is some. There is some. Hay un poco. Right? There is some. Igual acá. Si yo no quiero dar números, porque hay que estar contando cuántos. Bueno, there are some people. How many people work in your company? A few people working my company. A few people. ¿Sí? Entonces, yo puedo usar con este, puedo usar a few. Puedo usar few solamente. Ahí está. Few, que significa poquito, como que casi nada. A few, no mucho, pero algunos. ¿Right? Y también puedo usar some. Some puede ser usado para countable y no countable. También a lot. Entonces, aquí la gran diferencia en cuanto a cantidades, yo no quiero usar números, es el a few y el a little. A little para no contables y a few para contables. ¿verdad? Y ahí some y a lot son iguales. Y la gran diferencia radica en la pregunta. Si estamos hablando de countables, voy a usar how many. Uncountables, voy a usar how much. Yes. A ver. Ahora, vamos a ver, acá se sí. How many books do you read in a year? How many? Not many. Puede decir no muchos, pero en este caso no voy a decir not much, sino que many. No muchos, ¿eh? Solo uno, dos. How many books do you read in a year? Not many. Not many, only one or two. How many students are there in your class right now? Podemos decir only a few. Check. Only a few, solo algunos, pocos, right? Cuando yo digo only a few, es solo algunos pocos. O you can say there are some students in my class, o puede contarlo y decir there are 14 students in my class. Puede darme un número. Right? There are 14 students in my class. ¿Sí? Any question here? No question. Clear like the coffee. Preguntas, preguntas, preguntas. No, no questions.
No question, teacher.
Okay, perfect. Vaya. Voy a llamar a la attendance. Antes de mandar a los breakout rooms. Okay, Ángel.
Present.
Great, Ángel. ¿Qué tal de tormenta?
Súper fuerte, por eso no me conecté al inicio. Estaba exageradamente fuerte aquí.
Ay, a mí me daba miedo, mi pobre computadora.
Estaba terrible.
Pero gracias a Dios se calmó ya.
Aris, yo pensé que a la gata le daba miedo que se le fuera a mojar.
No, sí, se mojó. Se mojó. Venía pero en guinda bajo la lluvia.
Pobrecita la gatita.
Ella le encanta. La vi pasar corriendo cuando empezó el gran viento que casi volaba la pobre. Aristides, hello.
Present.
Excelente, Aristides. Denia. Denia Guadalupe. No, Denia here today. Oh my God, yo me estoy poniendo afónica. Denia, no here. Eduardo, next to. Eduardo. Edwin.
Present.
Great. Fátima. Fátima.
Present, teacher.
Hey, very good, Fátima. Nice to see you. Elizabeth. No. ¿Y dónde veo Elizabeth? No hay ninguna Elizabeth aquí. Isabel. Isabel.
Present.
Yes. Okay. Yo ya miro de más. Qué bueno, ¿verdad? Que estoy choca. Ya veo de más. Luis Mauricio.
Present, teacher.
Ok. María Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Great. Marisela. Marisela. No here, Marisela. Marlene.
Present, teacher.
Great. Maura. Maura, Maura.
Present, teacher.
Okay, nice, Maura, that you could connect. Nidia Marilyn. Nidia. Nidia, Nidia, Nidia. No here, Nidia. Okay, Oscar.
Present, teacher.
Great. Ricardo. minuto. Teresa.
Present teacher.
Nice. Walter.
Present teacher.
Excellent. Judy.
Present teacher.
Very good. Qué bueno que el agua calmó. Al menos aquí, no sé cómo está en su casa. Igual.
Aquí está lloviendo fuerte y tronando también y con ventarrón.
Así estuvo aquí tipo 6:30, 7 de la noche.
Uy. En Santa Tecla ya calmó bastante, pero sí hubo demasiado viento.
Tremendo.
Muy fuerte y mucho trueno.
Mire, oyó que la llamaban. Aquí viene la señorita Fiorella.
Ahí llegó la gata.
Oyó que la llamaban, no, Fifi. No. You listen. Anda pidiendo cariñito, dice. Ok, lo que hace es venir a echarse el agua encima, hermano.
Anda frillito.
Sí, anda frillito. Pero viene, se cuelga del vaso con agua, va de toma frío. Vaya, let's see. Nos vamos a ir al breakout rooms. You're going to complete this exercise. Check.
Perdón, teacher, a mí no me mencionó.
No, en serio, Yesenia, me la salté. Vamos a ver. Uy, qué barbaridad.
Quizá yo no escuché porque está tronando bien fuerte. Acá ya está lloviendo.
Probable. Sí, porque vamos. Teresa, here, right? Teresa. Walter. Yesenia.
Present teacher. Quizás no escuché teacher por sí, eso. A lo mejor sí me mencionó.
Pero
mejor
nos aseguramos, ¿verdad? Y Yuri.
Muchas gracias, teacher.
Okay.
Present teacher.
Excellent.
Present.
Okay, bye. This is the exercise that you're going to complete. Okay. This is the exercise that you're going to complete. I'm going to share it in the chat. I have to compartir porque si no voy a copiarlo a ustedes. Vaya, sí. Bueno, y sí. Ahí va. You see in the chat. You find the exercise that you're going to complete. Vamos a hacerlo juntos. Let's see, we are 13. I'm making numbers, right? Okay. Ready, one group of four, and the others are groups of three. Are you ready? Yes, yes.
Ready.
Okay, perfect. There you go.
El grupo
comenzamos.
De cuatro.
Sí, está bueno. Comenzamos entonces. Yo casi no oí la explicación porque aquí está cayendo una buena tormenta.
Tenemos que completar estas oraciones.
Ok.
La primera Was there much traffic on the road?
Se había
much.
Perdón, Alice.
Was yo creo que es what much. Was there number much traffic on the road?
Number one, yes.
Much.
Number three.
¿Cuál sería?
Vamos, pues.
La primera.
Okay. Was there?
Was there traffic on the road? Eso no se puede contar, ¿ve?
No.
No. Uncountable. Entonces usaremos
sí.
No me interesa.
Sí. Esta es la primera vez. Much traffic on the road.
Much the human.
Pero no lo vamos a poner.
Sí,
sí. Como dice, was there much traffic on the road? Uh-huh. Dice que sí hay mucho tráfico.
Ajá, es mucho.
La segunda también, vea.
Son contables.
Contables.
Son contables, ajá.
What the hell, la vacación.
En la cuarta también creo que es many, porque puedes contar los días de vacaciones. How many vacation days?
Days do you have in the year? Sí, ahí sería many.
The five does she have this here? Ella.
¿Qué es earn, teacher?
Earn. Gana, de gana, de una salary. Por ejemplo, win es si lo gana en una rifa, right? Pero earn es si lo gana como salario, trabajando.
Entonces sería much.
Se puede contar, entonces sería does she earn many money?
¿Es la palabra money countable o uncountable?
Money.
Nuestro salario es contable, teacher.
Can you say no. Salarios? En español sí, pero en inglés
no.
Entonces no. Sería much money.
Much money. How much money? Y fíjense que aquí hay un error. Hay que ser weren't. 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 Es que cambié la palabra people, pero ya no, se me fue. It wasn't.
Aquí weren't.
Sí, weren't. They weren't. What about time? Is that countable or uncountable?
Countable.
Mm-hmm.
How much time?
Uh-huh. Exactly. How are you doing?
Hola, teacher.
Hi, hi. ¿Cómo vamos?
Teacher, yo lo que he logrado comprender, la verdad, no mucho, ¿verdad? Porque, pues, comentaba con los compañeros que el uso de many es una cantidad cuando no, solo se calcula, pero no se sabe exactamente la cantidad. Y much, cuando exactamente podemos medir la cantidad. No sé si así sería la diferencia.
Vaya, ¿se acuerdan que al principio vimos cuáles cosas se pueden y cuáles no se pueden contar?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Entonces usamos much con las cosas que no podemos contar. Y many, entonces, sí. Entonces, por ejemplo, yo digo, how much coffee do you drink? ¿Cuánto café toma?
Una o dos tazas. Ajá.
Exactly.
Ahí sería many.
No, much. How much coffee do you drink? Yo puedo usar many si le digo, how many cups of coffee do you drink? Si ocupo
teacher,
cups, dígame, Edwin.
Por ejemplo, en la primera, was there many traffic sería, ¿verdad?
Much.
On the road.
No.
Sería much.
How much traffic? Acuérdense lo que les decía, ustedes pueden contar los buses, los carros, las rastras, las motos, pero no pueden, pero la palabra traffic es singular.
Sí.
Entonces, vaya, en lo que ustedes tienen que ver es esto, una, como una clave, digamos. Si tiene plural, ocupo many. Si la palabra no tiene plural, no puedo, porque many es solamente para plural.
Entonces, ah, ya.
Si no tiene plural, ocupo much, porque eso significa que la palabra no se puede contar. ¿Ya?
Ah, correcto.
Entonces, al revés lo estábamos haciendo, compañero.
Sí, yo veo.
Ajá, al revés. Sería entonces, was there much traffic in the road?
Sí.
Ese sería much. Sí. En el segundo, como si las monedas sí las podemos contar el dinero, entonces ahí sería many.
Pero es que dijo que plural. Plural es, cuando es plural es many, dijo ella. Cuando es singular es much.
¿En el segundo estamos hablando de plural?
Yo creo que no.
Una cosa, Yesenia. ¿Se acuerdan que al principio les mencionaba yo de aquellas palabras, por ejemplo, furniture? Furniture se refiere a los muebles, pero la palabra en sí no se cuenta. Usted puede contar los muebles, pero no puede contar la palabra furniture. Furniture es no contable, igual que traffic. Usted puede contar los carros, los buses, pero no puede, pero la palabra traffic es no contable.
Abarca todo.
Ajá, exacto. Entonces, cuando tenemos palabras así que reúnen en un todo, ¿verdad? En el caso de money también, que si usted se refiere a money, entran euros, yen.
Dinero en general.
Exacto. Entonces, si yo digo money, money is not countable. No puedo decir dineros, ¿verdad? No existe. No existe. Entonces, yo digo how much money. Porque la palabra money es no countable. Uh-huh. Entonces recuerden, si no tiene plural, es uncountable. Tiene plural, puede ser countable.
Pero en la tercera está negando, teacher.
Sí, de hecho aquí se me fue un error. Aquí tiene que ser there weren't. Pero igual, aunque esté en negativa o afirmativa la pregunta, la oración, people, ¿es countable o no countable?
No contable.
¿Estás segura? ¿Qué es
people? Ah, pues, es personas en la playa.
Ajá. People es
¿puedo contar?
The singular is person and the plural is people.
Entonces ahí es many, many, sí, me has dicho.
Porque tiene plural, exactly.
Porque es plural.
Ajá, yes. Ve y se nos repitió many.
Ah, sí. And does she.
Ajá.
Does she. Entonces, la tercera es many.
Sí, es many.
Okay.
Porque es plural.
Ajá, exacto. Bueno, you will have 1 minute and then I call you, okay? Okay. Everybody, nos queda un grupo todavía. Okay, perfect. Vamos. Vale. Fíjense que aquí se me fue un hermoso. Porque cambié la palabra en último momento y se me quedó esto en singular.
Ex. Teacher.
Ah. Yep. Tell me, Aristides.
I was gonna ask about it because
mm-hmm.
We were confused about it.
Yes.
Because wasn't and many and people wasn't quite nice. But now you corrected.
Yeah. So you say there weren't
many
people is plural. Yeah, there weren't many. There weren't many people at the beach. Was there?
Much.
Les voy a poner la. Okay. Vaya, let's see. So you say, was there
much?
Number two, how?
Many.
More.
¿Puedo contar el dinero?
No.
Cuento los dólares, los billetes, todo. Pero money has no plural, right? So you say?
Much.
How much money? Because money, no digo monies, right? How much money? Mm-hmm. Much money was on your coat. There weren't
many.
Mm-hmm. Many because singular person, plural people, right? About here, vacation days.
Many.
How many vacation days do you have in a year? And the next one, does she
much?
Does she earn much? Does she earn much money? How?
Many.
Many,
porque lleva we.
Ah, no, no tiene nada que ver. Ahí no tiene nada que ver.
Much time.
How much? Acuérdense que a lo que se van a pegar es que decíamos how much plus el noun, how many plus noun. Yo en este caso, mi noun que estoy usando es no count. Entonces yo digo how much. Porque si yo digo many, how many times, ya no es cuánto tiempo, sino cuántas veces. Right? So if I say, how many times do you eat? ¿Cuántas veces come? How many times do you eat? I eat 3 times a day. How much time do you spend eating? ¿Ya? Entonces ya ahí ya estamos contando el tiempo. ¿Cuánto tiempo nos falta para el final de la clase? Vamos a ver. How much time do we have left?
30 minutes.
30 minutes. Vale, hoy nos vamos a ir al manual. Vamos a stop sharing here. In the manual. In the manual, go to page 14. Page 14. Ready? Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Hey, Josh. Repeat. Hey, Josh.
Hey, Josh.
Hey, Josh.
I have a question for you.
I have a question for you.
Do you have paid vacations at your work?
Do you have paid vacations
at your job?
Yes, I do, Ruth.
Yes, I do, Ruth.
How about you?
How about you?
How about you?
Me too. I have paid vacations.
I have paid vacation.
How many days do you have in your vacations?
How many days do you have in your vacation?
Háganle la corrección. 20 days to be exact.
20 days to be exact.
How many bonuses do you have per year?
How many bonuses do you have per year?
How many bonuses do you have per year? I have 4 bonuses.
I have four bonuses.
What about you? And how much do you receive?
And how much do you receive?
I have just two. But each bonus is for more than $600.
But each bonus is for more than $600.
Mm-hmm. But each bonus is for more than $600.
Okay. Each bonus is for more than $600.
I want to move you here. Okay. Bye. Check this. These are some expressions that we use to ask about money. How much do they pay? How much? ¿Cuánto? Right? How much do they pay? How much do they charge? ¿Cuánto cobran? How much is it? How much is it? How much do you earn every month? Or how much do you earn monthly? How much do you earn every month? Or how much do you earn monthly? Okay, so these are some questions that we ask when we want to ask for money. Okay, now what you're going to do here in this exercise is circle the best question or the best option to complete the question. How much do they pay or how many do they pay? What do you think?
How much?
How much money? How much days do you have in your vacation? or how many days do you have in your vacation?
How many?
How much, how many days do you have on your vacation? Okay. Bye. Let's complete here. We have some questions, right? So what you're going to do is to use these questions in activity form. Use one of the questions above to complete the mini conversations. So if I say it is 50, it is 10:50. ¿Cuál es la pregunta?
How much is it?
Very clear. Okay, how much is it? Okay, so pay attention to the questions and then you complete, you write the question that corresponds to the answers given.
Can you go up? Can you go up? I want to see the questions.
A ver.
Oh, thanks. How much do you earn every month?
How much? How much do you earn every month, or how much do you earn monthly, right?
Monthly.
Okay, perfect. What about the next one?
How much do they charge?
How much do they
charge?
Charge.
Let's see.
How much do they charge? They take $23 per item.
How much do you charge every month?
How much do they pay? No queda. How much do they pay? O quieren cambiar. How much do you earn every month?
How much do you every month?
But look at the answer. The company pays.
How much do you pay?
How much do they pay?
How much do they pay? Tenemos las claves allí, ¿verdad? Cuando usted dice, how much do you earn, puede decir, how much money do you make? No es de que usted va a ir allá a empezar a ver cómo hace Cristo, ¿eh? Sino que cuando usted está trabajando, usted está haciendo dinero, right? How much money do you make? I make $545 monthly. How much money? O how much do you earn monthly? Ni es necesario ponerle money porque ya se sabe, ¿verdad? How much do you earn monthly? I make $545 monthly. Yeah. And then, how much do they pay? Este es lo que nos da la clave para usar esa pregunta, right? The company pays $690 with bonuses. Any question?
No.
Vaya, allí les voy a dejar 3 minutos para que ustedes respondan estas preguntas sobre ustedes. No les voy a pedir que reporten a los compañeros porque yo sé que cuando hablamos de esto es sagrado, ¿verdad? Entonces, solamente respóndalas en su notebook. Y si tiene duda, me dice. ¿Ok? Go. Finished. Finished.
Teacher.
Yes. Yes, you're done, right? Okay, perfect. Now, we are moving to page 16. Go to page 16. Ready? Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Let's repeat. Jeff, how are you doing?
Jeff. How are you doing?
How are you doing? I want to ask you.
I want to ask you.
How many days a week do you work?
How many days a week do you work?
Hey, Ben. Well, I work 5 days a week. And you?
I work five days a week. And you?
That's great. I work 4 days a week. I work 4 days.
That's great.
I work four days a week, and sometimes on Saturdays.
Really? On Saturdays?
Really?
On Saturdays.
Do you work extra hours? How much money do they pay for each extra hour?
How much money do they pay for each extra hour?
Yes, I work extra hours when there is too much work to do.
Yes, I work extra hours when there is too much work to do.
Each extra hour is around $10.
I see.
Well, sometimes I see. Sometimes there is not much time, right? Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. Right now, check. We are on page 16. Yes, page 16. I'm going to send you a couple of minutes for you to go practice the conversation. Page 16, everybody. Ready. This time we are going to be in pairs. I'm going to make 6 groups for you to practice the conversation in pairs. Ready? Page 16, Manuel, everybody. Great, there you go. check if you can join. I think we're Yesenia, Mari, and Maura. Vamos a ver. Estoy moviendo, a ver si ahí me le dan chance de divertirse al grupo. Cheque, Mari. María, María.
Podemos descargar siempre en el enlace que mandaron, ¿verdad?
Imagina. En la plataforma, sí. En la plataforma, ahí está. ¿Verdad?
Está en la plataforma, está en WhatsApp.
Ahí, okay. Está en WhatsApp.
Sí.
¿En WhatsApp está también?
Sí.
Pero yo hasta ahora entré, quizás por eso no lo logré ver.
Ah, es probable. Ah, vaya. Pero ahí está en la plataforma, Yesenia.
Sí, ahí lo voy a buscar entonces, teacher. Ajá, muchas gracias. Muy bien. Ok, ahí sería una conversación, me imagino, ¿verdad? Sí.
Practice the conversation.
Ok.
How many days are we to you work?
Hey Ben, well, I work 5 days a week. And you?
Thanks, I read work for weekday in sometimes on Saturdays.
Really? On Saturdays? Do you work extra hours? And how much money do they pay for each extra hours?
Yes, I work extra hard when there is too much. What do you do? Do extra hours? It's around 10.
I see. Well, sometimes there is not much time, right? Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Okay. And now I Ben.
Okay.
Jeff, how are you doing?
Mario.
Absolutely. Ah, ese no lo tengo, absolutely. Bueno. Sí. Okay.
Okay.
Entonces, ahora yo Ben.
Ahora, ¿verdad? Es usted Ben y yo soy Jeff.
Jeff, how are you doing? I want to ask you how many days a week do you work?
Hey, Ben. Well, I work 5 days a week. And you?
Thank you. Creo que sí se dice, ¿verdad? Greet.
Thank you.
And greet. I work for
That's great.
8 days.
That's great.
That's great.
That's great. That's great. Okay, thank you. That's great. I work for 8 days in some time on Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
Jeff? Jeff? Se me perdió.
Se perdió Jeff? Jeff Walter? The microphone, Walter.
Yes.
Ajá. Sí, yo creo que se han de ver verdad.
Sí. Le damos una vez más.
Démosle, entonces hoy yo ven y usted Jeff.
Vaya.
Jeff, how are you doing? I want to ask you how many days a week do you work?
Hey Ben, well, I work 5 days.
Really? On Saturdays? Do you work extra hours? And how much money do you pay? Do they pay for each extra hour?
Yes, I work extra hours when there is too much work to do. Each extra hour is around $10.
I see. Well, sometimes there is not much time, right?
Absolutely,
Maria. And teacher says absolutely.
Absolutely. Do you work extra hours and how much money do they pay for each extra hour?
Yes, work extra work where there is too much work to do. Each extra hour is around $10.
I see. I will. Sometimes there is not much time.
Hi, Mary. I saw you have problems to join. Okay. Almost left. Everybody.
Hello, hello.
Everybody. Vamos a cantar. Everybody.
Exacto.
Pero no me hacen la barra. Yeah, yeah. Ok, let's see. Me faltan. Sí.
Sí, creo que están practicando.
¿Qué están esperando hasta el último segundo que se los... Ahí está. Ok, ya se los trajo Zoom. Perfecto. Vaya. Let's go to the manual again. Nice. Check. Here, again, you're going to circle the words, how much or how many, right? How much or how many? How much hours or how many hours a day do you work?
How many?
How many?
Okay. How many? I need my pencil here. How many hours a day do you work? And number two?
Much.
How much? How much do they pay for? How much do they pay per hour? Okay. Now look at this. As we were saying before, we use how many for countable nouns, hours, days, weeks, years. How many days a week do you rest? How many weeks a month do you rest? My
rest.
Well, how many weeks a year do you rest? 3-4 weeks?
Only. Two? No, no, rest.
3 weeks. You have the
teacher will rest to
4 days.
Six weeks.
Six the teacher weeks. Rest 6 weeks in six the weeks. Year.
Yeah, kind of.
Maybe.
Kind of, right? It's so probably, we have the Holy Week. Then August
the weekend, whole week. August weekend.
All December. So we have 4 weeks there. Yeah, 6 weeks. 2 weeks of November.
Not all time.
Yo he vivido engañando todo este tiempo, entonces. Yo no descanso en este tiempo.
That, Luis, we work almost 24/7, right, Angel? 24/7. We never finish.
Yes.
Yeah, so that's why.
We don't have a weekend.
No, we don't have a weekend. The classes don't finish at the schedule.
Never, never finish.
We continue the 24-hour days, the 7 days a week. So that's why we need 7 days, 7 to 6 weeks to rest.
Yes.
Es para que se sientan envidiosos. Okay, so
good, good, Luis.
Sí, porque de aquí todos van a querer salir haciéndose teachers. Nah.
Yeah.
Okay,
sí.
So how much is for uncountable, right? So how much money do they pay per extra hour? How much money do they pay for extra hour? How much time? Remember, how much money, how much time do we have? How many days? How many hours? How many weeks? How many hours a day do you work? How many hours a day do you work? Who can tell me? How many hours a day do you work?
8 hours?
You work 8 hours?
No. I work 10 hours.
On Mondays, I work
10 hours.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because I have extra hours.
two extra hours.
Now the next question. How much money do they pay extra hours?
$10.
Okay.
$15.
Oh, listen, $15. How many days a week do you rest? How many days a week do you rest?
Only one day.
One day. Me too. Yes. Only one day.
Okay.
Angel rests 2 days.
No. Angel rests 5.
Really, one day. One day.
No. Okay. You work one day Marlene. And 5 days.
Marlene, how many days a week do you rest?
Ya voy. Ahorita me están preguntando. Ahorita me están
preguntando. How many days?
Perdón, teacher.
How many days a week do you rest?
¿Cuántos días trabajo?
No, ¿cuántos días descansa?
One weekend day.
One day.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Uh-huh. One day. Okay. Good. Aristides, how many hours a day do you work?
8 hours.
Okay. You work 8 hours. Very good. Let's see. Tell me, Isabel, how much time do we have before we finish the class?
How much time
do we have before we finish? Before we finish the class, how much time do we have?
A little,
yeah. We have a little time. Okay.
It's...
Well, you can say we have only 5 minutes, right? We have only
5 minutes. Exactly.
Questions here?
I have a question.
Tell me.
I have to say how much time do we have or how much time do we have left? But Can I say how many minutes do we have? Yeah. Or do we have left?
You can say that. How many minutes?
Or how many hours?
How many hours? How many days? Imagine that you have a project to do, right? And you say, hey, how many minutes? No, how many days do we have left? How many days are we missing? Present the project, right? How many days? Or how much time?
Yes. Okay, thanks, teacher.
Okay, you're welcome. Tomorrow, les voy a asignar un homework, yo hoy. Y lo pueden trabajar ahorita en lo que yo paso attendance. Check. You're going to use how many or how much to complete these sentences. How many or how much? How much money is in a bank? Ooh, how much money is in a bank? Paper is countable or non-countable?
Uncountable.
Bye. Let's complete. Let's complete the exercise while I call attendance. That's page 17. Y yo paso lista en lo que ustedes trabajan. Vamos a ver. Angel. Angela.
Present.
Present. Great. Aristides.
Present.
Great. Daniel. Oh, yeah. Eduardo Ernesto. Edwin.
Present.
Fatima.
Present, teacher.
Great. Isabel.
Present.
Okay, Luis.
Oh, present.
Martínez.
You are asleep, Luis.
Ay, ¿acaso?
Yes.
María. María, María, María. María, por ahí andaba. Okay. Marisela. Marlene.
Present, teacher.
Maura. Maura. Maura, Maura.
Present, teacher.
Okay, great. Nidia, Marilyn. Nidia. No. Oscar.
No here.
Oscar.
Desapareció.
Oscar.
Y vio también que le estaba fallando mucho la señal por la tormenta, porque sí lo vi que estaba aquí en clase.
Sí, 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 por ahí estaba. Y dos veces me dijo, pero ya no. Teresa. Teresa.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Walter.
Present, teacher.
Yesenia.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Yuri.
Present, teacher.
Okay, perfect. Estamos. Very nice. Vaya. Check. Vamos a ver quién se queda conmigo. ¿Se acuerdan? Martes. Ah, no, lunes hoy, ¿verdad? Denia es.
Lunes.
Denia, Denia se queda. Ok. Denia no está aquí, ¿verdad? ¿Tengo algún volunteer que se quiera quedar conmigo?
Teacher. Hola. I wanna take the one to one.
Okay, okay.
If I can. Sure. If I can.
Okay, perfect.
Okay. Because last Friday it was my turn, but
oh.
I couldn't be on a class. So
okay, okay. Sí, Teresa aprovechó.
Ah.
Muy bien, muy bien. Mañana le toca a Eduardo hoy. Así que allí, si Eduardo no se conecta mañana, ahí ven quién quiere quedarse. Miércoles le toca a Edwin, jueves Fátima y viernes Isabel. Sí, así vamos. Y Ángel tiene repetición, le toca el último día también. Okay.
Okay, excellent.
Bueno, see you tomorrow. Mañana vamos a checar la tarea. Okay. Bye bye.
Hey, good night.
Night.
Bye.
See you.
Good night.
Bye.
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 Good night.
Take care.
Happy
good
weekend.
Night. Enjoy.
Enjoy the weekend.
Enjoy all the week. Yeah.
Yes. Bye.
Bye bye. Take care. Okay, Aristides, tell me. Do you have any question?
No, but I just want to practice my speaking.
Okay, perfect. Perfect. Okay, we can practice. I can ask you some questions and then you can tell me, right?
Okay.
Last Friday, we were talking about routine, right? We were talking about daily routine and what are the activities that you usually do at work. We were also using some expressions. Just for simple present, yeah?
Okay,
so tell me, what do you do every day? What's your daily routine at work?
Well, let me start by saying that I am a teacher. A math teacher. And
what subject do you teach?
Mathematics, math.
Oh my goodness.
Math. So first, we are working in a virtual form. So I have to connect from my house. And that's why I have able time to do some other things, not only, well, I'm gonna tell you about my Monday. First, I get up early because I have to go to one college because I work in two colleges and one university. Always teaching math in the three places.
University, so, you continue virtual or you go in a presential way?
I am continuing virtual.
Okay.
Actually, I work on Monday from 6 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. So some Mondays I'm gonna be late for class. Some Monday. This Monday, I scheduled them exam, so I was able to be early in the class.
Oh, that's nice. But
let me continue.
Give them an exam every Monday.
Okay, let me continue. So I go to one college named Colegio Centroamérica here in Sonsonate. I'm from Sonsonate.
Oh, I see.
And in this college, we have to record our class and then we have to send them. And that is part of the virtual way. But we also given online classes. So, well, we send them the video. And afterwards, if they have questions, so they can ask us, or the teachers, well, they can ask me the questions in the online class.
So you do the two things, synchronic and asynchronic.
Exactly. But I have a schedule. I don't remember horarios.
A schedule.
So after I finish my recording, because I have a schedule every video on Classroom or four sections, four grades. So I am able to go to the gym. So because while my students are watching the video of the class, I am able to be on the gym.
Mm-hmm. That's nice.
But I have a question. What is the difference between I exercise or I work out?
When you say I exercise, can be whatever type of exercise. But if you say I work out, it's like I want to get my muscles, right?
Ah, mm-hmm. Okay.
Work out at the gym to get.
Okay.
But exercise can be just aerobics, right? Uh-huh. It can be any type of exercise. It's very general.
Okay, I get it now.
But can exercise at home, but you work out at the gym, right?
Okay, I get it now. So I went to the gym for workout, and at 2 p.m. I have an online class, and well, with a section that I cannot send them a video because I only work with them for just 2 hours. So I cannot record a video for just a little time. So I give them the online class, and afterwards I get in to prepare for my university class that it starts at 6 p.m. and I finish it at 8:30, but as I told you before, I am going to try to finish it even before the hour, so I can be just in time for the English class.
Perfect.
And tomorrow I have to go to work to another college by the morning, and the college name, Colegio La Santísima Trinidad, is a little Catholic, so I have to pray and do all the Catholic things. But I am Catholic too, so it is not a
problem for you.
Exactly. Well, and afterwards I have online classes with the students from the other college, Colegio Centroamerica, and then at night I'm gonna be free just for the class.
That's nice. Wow, that's a busy schedule, right? And something good about teachers is that you can move and your schedule varies. It's not the same schedule every day, right?
Exactly.
You have different things to do, or different schedules to do. But what we were saying before, right, in classes, that the activities never finish, right? Sometimes I'm getting messages at about 11 or 12. If I'm awake, I answer, because I said, this guy hardly ever connects or hardly ever tries to investigate. So, okay. And I answer even at midnight, right? So it's regarding, right? It's regarding. So
exactly.
We have
You're right. Our
pay. And tell me, how is it teaching math in virtual? Is it easy? Do you find it easier to teach it in virtually, or you prefer to go to the school and do it in a presential way?
Well, I think there are two perspectives. Mm-hmm. One perspective from the students and the other perspective from us, because from the comfortable way, I feel more comfortable to be at my home, mm-hmm. in my home. It is more comfortable. And I have all the tools. So I can teach it even better, I think. But the other perspective is from the student that they are at home, and the most common comment is that I get bored, I am sleepy. Exactly, and a lot of things. So I think the student is not mature enough to this virtual way. So
a lot of discipline.
Exactly. So for them, it's better to get back to the way it was before. But for us, for me, I think it is better in this way, because I do my job. I try to organize my class. I try to do my best when I am explaining to them, and I try to use every technology I have on my hand to improve it. So from my perspective, it's better this way. For example, learning English in this way is very cool, let me tell you. Because the things I like the most about these classes is when you speak only in English. Mm-hmm. Because you let me improve my listening.
Exactly.
And sometimes I understand everything you say, because I like to watch TV series. Well, not TV series, on streaming platforms. I like Netflix, Disney Plus, and HBO Max.
And you watch in English.
Exactly. I like to watch the series and movies in English and put subtitles on English too, so I can listen the pronunciation of the words. But as I told you before, I want to improve my speaking. That's why I stay on this one-to-one.
Hey, excellent. Excellent. And definitely the best way to improve speaking is speaking. Unfortunately, with our students, it's a little bit hard sometimes, right? They want to speak, they want to learn to speak, but they don't want to speak. They want to learn how to speak, but they are not used to listen. And what you're doing is very good, because if you want to improve speaking, you have to listen, yeah? Because remember, it's like if you have a person who cannot listen, they have a big difficulty to speak. And in a language, it's exactly the same. If you don't listen, speaking becomes very hard, right? And this on the other way, if you want to learn how to write correctly, reading is the clue, right? Because with exactly. Reading, you improve all the reading skills and the vocabulary, and that helps at the moment of writing. If you see, for example, all the writers that we have, they got engaged in writing by reading about some other people that were writing. And sometimes that's why they have a special gender, because they were reading about somebody and then they write not exactly the same, but kind of similar, right?
Yeah.
And that's what reading helps for writing, and listening helps for speaking.
Yeah, I like to reading too, but sometimes this part is difficult for me speaking, because I get nervous and my tongue tied and everything.
Yeah, that's normal, right? But with the time, you get familiarized with that. And at the end, you feel like, oh, it's nothing happens. I can say whatever and nothing happens, right? So
yeah,
continue watching videos, right? Continue watching movies in English and you will see that it will help you a lot.
Yeah.
Continue practicing and learning the language.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay, I don't know if you have any other comments or question or anything.
I don't know. Maybe it's not. I don't.
Okay, perfect. Well, see you tomorrow, Dan. Have a great night. It stopped raining.
Thanks for you too. But here is it still raining.
Really?
Are you in Cincinnati,
right?
Yeah.
What's her name? Let me see. We have Teresa. Teresa is in Sonsonate.
And do you want to hear something funny? She is my colleague.
Oh, really?
We work at the same place.
Maricela too.
Yeah, she is too. She was, I think, because she's not anymore, but we have a relationship.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice. Yeah, I thought when you told me that you were a teacher, I thought you were in the same school as Angel, because Angel is a teacher too.
But maybe he's
in San Diego. He's in San
Diego. So he's not. We are so far.
Teresa, yes, she's in San Diego. So that's nice.
Yeah. And sometimes we practice the lessons after the class.
Hey, that's great. That's great. That's fantastic. That's something that will really help you both, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Practicing together.
And you she's waiting for me, actually.
Oh, nice. I won't go to sleep until you go. Okay, go then.
Mm-hmm.
And continue talking with her. Okay, okay. And please have a great time. And see you
Thanks. Tomorrow. Thanks for you too. Bye. Good night.
Care.
Bye-bye.